going to be warm over here. It's freezing. We're stalking some trophy mouflon, and there's three quite large rams. That's very, very elusive, and it's not very easy stalking today. And I think they've actually moved further down the valley, so I think we can move on and see what we can find. The important thing is actually, if we do get near to some mouflon, is they can hear our voice a long, long way away. So whilst we can be quite noisy underfoot, we must keep our voices down all the time because they pick it up very, very quickly. This is where the old bear's been pulling out of a bee's nest. You see how they claws it, pulled it out that way. Amazing. It's quite deep as well. Must be big bears around here. It's amazing, this place. We have access to a quite a few hunting grounds, all along the coast, and Artemis have been taking us along the road, and we just park up, as you see here now, and we're just glancing. It seems a bit strange because we've got cars going behind us, people beeping their horns. It's not a thing you see in the UK, but they're very open and very, very happy for people to hunt. And what is fascinating is how quite a large mouflon can actually just disappear into cover. And you know, we were spotting a really nice trophy. Now it's gone and we're moving on.
It's too young, he's only 3 years old, mm-hmm. and his antlers are not growing as wide as they should, they're going into his jaw. Mm-hmm. So that's one of the elements we're looking when we're trying to call the animal
yes.
out.
Yes, yeah.
So this animal is to be called out and shot
at. Yes.
But we're trying to get you a better trophy. Mm. So that is our plan.
Yeah.
We've seen the animal, we've taken a few pictures, and now we're trying to find a better one.
Okay.
A better one for you.
Okay, all right. Okay.
There's an outcrop going away from us, about 650 metres away. And halfway up there, we got about four or five mouflon. There's two rams. And one of the rams has got a fairly large head on it. So we've been sitting here for about half an hour, just glassing, looking through scopes and spotting scopes to see what we can look. And I think what we can do now is that the animals actually are now starting to feed. So they're coming down off the mountain into the gully there. So what we can do is we're going to work our way up around the other side of the gully there, and hopefully we can get a shot across that mountain there. So it's probably about a 250 metre shot. Probably got about an hour's worth of light left, so we need to tab on a wee bit and hopefully find ourselves a mouflon ram. Really exciting. We found ourselves a decent ram, 600 metres away. We stalked up to it within 300 metres, spent about half an hour looking at it, and the last moment before I was about to take a shot, our guides advised that it was too good for a cull animal, so the decision was not to shoot it, which is fine. That's no problem. That's their decision. They're experienced hunters, that they have to manage the mouflon, and they felt very strongly between the three of them that actually it was too good to take out. So fine. Very disappointing for that's hunting. So whilst it's been a long day, we've been up since 4 o'clock this morning, been quite hard work. It's just such beautiful surroundings, and you can't beat hunting like this. And it's not all about what you're shooting, it's actually the experience of stalking. I just absolutely love this type of go, get your rucksack, get your rifle, and let's have a go. And that's what it's all about. And if you don't find an animal today, that's some hunting for you. That's what it's all about.
We'll be right back.
Wow. Yes, we had a pinch, as Dean would say, a bit of pinch of luck there. We're walking through the bush, and then suddenly one of the Paulo suddenly saw a ram running down the bottom of the ravine, a very steep ravine. So we shot over the top here, over these rocks, jumping around. Okay, and we dropped down onto it, and suddenly had to make a very, very quick shot here. Ram comes up over the other side of the ravine and comes across, and just had to jump down, put my rucksack on here, get loaded, get ready to go. Went along about 40 metres and I just take him straight through the shoulder, and looks like a good kill. But it's all about preparation. I made sure my rifle was all set properly, my scope. I knew exactly what to do, drop down onto it. But it happened so, so quickly. And if I'd forgotten to set my scope up properly or didn't have my kit properly, I would have probably missed that opportunity because he was running away. So all was last minute, but all out of the excitement. We've been on Mouflon for a good day yet, and we've seen so many animals. And we've got very close, and we've had to turn quite a few good ones away because the knot's not big enough. And suddenly, bang, within 3 minutes, we're onto one and we shot one. So that's hunting for you. Still a bit shaky, but that is absolutely brilliant. I absolutely love that. And hopefully we've got ourselves a nice looking ram. So, brilliant. I hate these rocks. They're so sharp and so unforgiving. Looks good here. Good shot. Where it needs to be. It still ran on, didn't it? Really beautiful. So, Dean, how do we know how old this animal is?
This gap shows that yes. This is a 1 year.
Yes.
This is second year.
Ah, okay, yes.
And this should be third year, so that means this Mouflon is in his fourth year. But the easiest way to make a mistake is to grade a trophy right on the field.
Yeah, yeah. The Mouflon and to me also the Chamois are the most beautiful animals I've had the privilege to shoot. I mean, just look at them. I mean, this is in their summer coats, it's a lot lighter, but in the winter they're a lot darker, and they have a big white spot here. Yeah, so I think they're just beautiful, stunning animals, and to see them, the way they move across the mountains. And yesterday we had about 20-30 of them skittling across the mountains, and it's just beautiful to see. But it's also the noise of all the pebbles, all the rocks falling down the side of the mountain. So we're very, very pleased, and it's just nice to, and a good shot. That's the most important thing. Yeah. We dispatched it quick as we could, so that's great. I aimed for the shoulder. I was trying to go for a safe shot, and it looks like I've actually gone just behind the shoulder blade there, but it's gone straight through and out the other side. So in some ways, probably the perfect shot. I thought perhaps I was a wee bit more forward. I was playing safe, but it's gone straight through. We're using on the 308, a Hornady 150 grain interbond. The new white tail they've got coming out. But I went for an interbond because I want something a bit more penetration, a bit harder jacket for the Mouflon and also for the ball later on. But I'm very pleased with the shot. Did the job perfectly well. Yeah, very, very pleased with it.